Hello, I'm Richard Raffan. In this video you're going to see how I made this little sheoak, forest sheoak box. It's a West Australian timber. Little flat kind of thing you might use for jewellery, rubber bands, I don't know. We all have little boxes to put things in. Or we should have. I was going to turn these two little bits of forest sheoak. It's a West Australian timber. It's got a very nice figure to it. I was going to make two little dishes, and then I realised that I could make a shallow box. Now, I'm going to make the base first. I'm pretty challenged on how I'm going to hold this with the chucks I've got these days. So I'm going to do the base first. Now the main thing about the base is there are a few little splits. There's one there which seems to go in about an eighth of an inch. Not too bad there, but the main thing is up here there's a knot which comes out there. So the choices I have there, I could glue the knot in place, but generally I prefer not to. I could go down to that level or into that, basically eliminating the knot. I don't have a chuck. It's a little bit shallow to use a screw chuck, so I'm going to use this 130mm chuck with dovetail jaws, and that means I can just plonk that in there and turn off the bottom. Now ideally I would turn this so that it fits the chuck exactly, but I've got this flat on it, it's not going to do it. So I'm going to proceed to flatten the bottom and we'll just see what happens, but probably going to end up with a foot this size and it will fit into the step jaws, the larger of the step jaws. So first off, just skim it off. And this stuff scrapes very nicely. Oh, it's a little bit rough there. That needs to come off first with a half-inch spindle gouge, just using the wing of the tool. Doesn't sound very sharp. I'll try the other one I've got. Much better. I'll just dispose of the other one, so I don't even think of using it. Right, so that's a smooth surface up near the rim, and then take a sheoak up back to the middle. We'll come up a few ribs. I just want to get this smooth, so I can see where the splits are. Looking, the grain looks terrific. Almost got it too much on the quarter, and I want that very slightly dished, which it is at the moment. There's a little kind of pimple just in the middle, which is just there, and the way to get rid of that, just back the rest off a little bit, and then I can start with the scraper underneath, just raise the handle, that goes through the middle. Don't need to push against the wood, just bring the handle down, pivot the edge in about half a millimeter through the wood. And we'll use this, which will be fit into the step jaws. Now these jaws have got a nice crisp inner lip, so they'll grip on even 1 or 2 millimeters. The shear scraper, use flat, I really like to take stuff straight out of a chuck finished if I can, and a little form like this probably looks better for being on a foot. So the idea is to have the foot exactly the right size for the chuck. The 3/8 spindle guides going in. On its side, so I can get into the top of the foot and then just round that over. It's just not, again, sounding very sharp. So just hone that up. You can see the difference. And across the bottom, need to make sure it is going to sit on its rim. Could be slightly more concave, just slightly dished in the center there. And we'll just use the corner, maybe a bit of decoration on the bottom. Extremely difficult to see with this light exactly where that line was. Okay, so sand that. .180 grit. Just give it a little go to make sure it don't need to go back to the coarser grit, which I don't hear. Works very nice, helps at all. This is going to get finished with beeswax. There's just a lump of beeswax. Build up a sticky layer. There's a sock I've got here, cotton, is full of wax at the moment, and there's a little bit of boiled linseed oil in there as well. So it's a really nice rag to finish with at the moment. There's almost too much wax in it. And find the odd clean bit and get the surplus off. That looks all right. And the lid is going to be, will just fit flat on top. Now I'll get this roughed out now too. This has got little splits on the top here. So that will be the top. And what I'll do is skim the bottom off and put a recess in so that I can then grab it from the other side and just grip as little as possible here. So it only needs to be about 1/8 of an inch in. Can almost have a spacer behind. Right, that looks reasonably okay. Just You see how, yeah. No. Very little to take off there. So, this is going to be a lid. Can be slightly hollow inside. I'll take that out with a half inch spindle guide again. I only need enough out so that I can get somewhere to grip the blank from the inside. So I'm going to use the 3/4 inch square end and put it about there. It's really just like a recess in the bottom of a bowl or a plate. And I'm going to use the skew on its side just to get in underneath. We're going to take a little scrape that side. Doesn't look like much, but the chuck will grip quite happily there. I can probably make that a bit deeper, I think. Just step this out from the middle. And undercut that. Just dovetail it very slightly. And the advantage of doing this with a skewed chisel is that the side is an edge as well, so that you can just rotate the skew very slightly and get a little bit of dust off the edge. Right, sand that. Jump there was because I let the sanding, I was pushing too far over to that side, and the paper just lifts or grabs enough, takes your fingers over here, and you're still pushing that way, so you go back to where you were. Years ago I broke three knuckles doing that. Enough oil and wax in there to do the job. Right, so that's the inside of the lid done, and change the chuck. And next time is next job is to get the base finished. This goes, this little foot goes into there, and because this is a nice crisp dovetail, that will grip perfectly happily. It won't come out. So next thing is to see what happens to this knot. Just true it up first. The knot came out. So there's a hole there. And the hole could be decorative, could be not. The overall proportions don't really look too bad. But I've got very little timber there to hang on to that knot. So another relevant thing is how much wood I've got available here. I think I'm going to just take the knot away. So I'll work down towards that. I'll be able to feel what's happening. And since it's going that way, I probably won't have to come up that far. And begin to see it. I'll just take all that away. Right, now I can see what I've got. The next thing really is to flatten off the top. It's really a question of now, do I want a wider, shallower dish, or a narrower, deeper dish? And I'll probably go for halfway between the two. Yeah. So I'm going to come down to about there. So first thing is to take a shear cut that way, which I can do with the spindle gouge. Going to put a little bit of a curve on it. So I just prefer the curves to straight lines generally. Right, so that'll be that'll look quite good, I think. And I need to drill a depth hole, which I'm using currently my little quarter inch spindle gouge. Got a very long fingernail grind, and there are grooves on the back, so I can see the depth I want to drill to. That's going to be like the second one down. There. Right, open this up with, I can use the bowl gouge to start with, 3/8 deep through your bowl gouge. Main thing I've got to worry about here is that as I go in, you can have this series of coves, and it's very easy to get those deeper than the hole. down that far, and then use the 3/4 inch scraper, square end scraper, which isn't square. It's got a very slightly skewed, very slight curve, so I can't get both corners in onto a flat surface at once. Slight curve there, so bring it up very slightly. Doesn't sound terminally thin, fortunately, so one of these chucks, you can take them out and test the thickness anyway. Oh, heaps. So I can go down another 1/8 of an inch there. Beginning to sound better. Across the inside, if I want to know what's happening, got my little multi straight edge, and I can get that in there. What I want to see is an even shadow cast, which you won't be able to see, but the straight line here casts a shadow on the bottom, and you just want that to be nice and even. At the moment it dips in the middle, and I can feel that dip. Do it. Grit. Doesn't take long. Back to the yellow, the 180. put some just straight linseed, boiled linseed in there, just so I can get a bit more liquid than the wax, the sun which gets easy flows into the corners. And then come back, put a bit of wax in on this time as well. This be a useful little tray if the lid ever gets lost, or if it doesn't get a lid. Yeah, so that's quite nice, and I don't think that will go onto there. No. This will need this chuck. I really want to be able to fit this lid properly, so it's going to have a little tenon which goes in. This is the top, and I've got to get rid of these splits. So what I'm going to do is get rid of the splits, put a small foot on it so I can reverse it in this chuck, and then it'll make my lid fitting easier. Really, the point I'm trying to get over is that you can do an awful lot with these chucks once you've got everything true. Grip it around there. You just need enough of an angle there that I can get the jaws into grip. Use the skew, just undercut that slightly. Need to know the diameter of the, let's find some dividers. Need to know the width of the inside here. Transfer this. So I want a teeny tenon on there, which will just align keep the lid in its place, and it's on the base. So we just take out a little shoulder here. In on that line, lining the bevel up with the liner mark, the diameter. It's a little bit difficult to see on this. Let's see if that does fit. Tight. This needs to be a little bit looser than that. I'm going to cut this down a bit. Get that screwed up on the rim first. Now, to true up that with without too much risk, which you do have with the gouge. I can use the side, the bevel side on the skew, just dropping the handle slightly, rolling it in. So you just get a little bit of dust off there. Do that again for you. Right, so I can sand that. So we now have this elegant looking pot, so I'm going to just need to find out where to what diameter to make the lid. So I'm going to mark it and I'm going to do it out of your sight, but where I can see it. So it'll be about there. Now that goes back on the chuck. Gently. Doesn't feel sharp enough. And try another one. Neither does that, so quick grind. In from each face, so you limit the likelihood of it splintering. Just kind of using the size to shear scrape. And see how that looks. I'm just going to be able to pick the lid up like that. So that's pretty well there. Now it's really a question of what do I want to do with the lid. Now there's a split there. I'd like to get rid of that. Just mark where it is. Just off there. Round that over, get the just underneath there. Not going back on the lathe, but on the chuck. It'll just get sanded now. Sounds solid enough. Really gripping the paper, so gonna crisp it. Softening that corner with sanding. Quite a bit of oil on this wax, so build up a good layer. So here we are. And I'll have a look at it up here.